other dignitaries. Obviously, this is an academic session, but rather I'm interested in converting that academic point to practical sessions which I can pinpoint. As you know, the law which deals the disaster is Disaster Management Act 2005. And I will point four aspects in which I am discussing thereafter. The section 2E of the Act defines what is a disaster management, how we have to face a disaster management. It has four points. It says planning, organizing, coordinating, and implementing. Obviously, when we come for an implementation, when we go for an implementation, we have to face a lot of issues. I'm pointing on that aspect. I'll point out five issues that we have to face when we go to the field in connection with the rehabilitation works. We all are aware, the government has issued an order in this regard. That is circular number, government order number 13/2018, dated 16/8/2018. GO number is 13, which says some conditions which gives compensation to the people, to the sufferers of this incident. It says, right from the beginning itself, it creates some confusion. It says, the houses has to be locked in water for 2 days. So those houses which locked in water for more than 2 days are eligible for the preliminary compensation of ₹10,000. You are aware, in the legislature also, they have raised a dispute that why you are insisting on this 2 days issue. Suppose it may be 1 day. Or for perhaps for an hour, some hours, but the damages must be similar. So the issue of 2 days, now they have diluted it. I think so, they have diluted it. Then another aspect is it's limited only to houses. Like my friend said, how about the industries? There are a lot of business concerns which faces much damage. But the circular says it's only confined to houses that too for 2 days to be lodged in water. Then the issue which starts, today morning also I got a call that the data collection is being done by the field officers in connection with the BLOs, ward members, these people will collect the data and they will give to village officer. Village officer will countersign it and forward it to Tahsildar. It is from the Tahsildar, they will transfer to the bank account. Issue starts there itself. Last day, my friend, he was a counselor, Panchayat member. He gave the actual number of the persons who were affected. He didn't give too much. So he took the correct number. But the adjacent ward, in order to help the people, he have included more people. Conflict started there itself. So when the interest comes there. So to that aspect, we have to assure that while giving the list to the authorities, revenue authorities, what will be the criteria? We will get complaints from there itself. So I point out, now they have put a cutoff date and certain persons who are enlisted before the cutoff date are getting the money now, ₹10,000 now. How about others? Certain other people, they are waiting in the queue, checking SMS in their bank account, whether the money has come or not. That is the primary issue now we are facing when we go into the field. And second aspect, that yet to come, 4 lakh for total loss. They have fixed a criteria up to 75%. If the loss is calculated more than 75%, it will be termed as total loss. To that account, they will cost 4 lakh rupees. Probably in our area, it will be a minimum number which we have to find out. Then 6 lakh is for loss of plot, that also depend upon the data. So I would say, while going around with this GO, we have to face five issues. One is inclusion of the beneficiaries. Who all are to be included, whether those persons who are included are genuine, and the other persons who are waiting for their queue. That is first issue. Second issue is regarding there are a lot of Chinese-ness. Fishermen, I know that there are a lot of fishermen all over that area, or the even licensed and unlicensed fish nets they have got. So how about the taking the data of those issues. Then industries, business concerns, those aspects were not attended in the circular. That is the second issue. Third one, dealing with bank. You know, RBI has issued circulars regarding the bank transactions. In this circular also, it was specific to the point that minimum balance shall not be cut, shall not be deducted from the account. But there are instances in which even giving this penny of 10,000, minimum balance has been deducted from several banks. They said they have not received any official communications. But government says, if the GO says, it shall not be deducted. So we are facing issues on that aspect. It is the third one. And fourth one, loss of documents. So you are aware, if you know, now we are facing the, if you do, you lost your voter ID, you can get it through the through online. It's not much issue now. Then Aadhaar card, you will get e-Aadhaar. Going to Akshaya Center, you will get e-Aadhaar. Then Ration card also government is serving it. Regarding the title deeds, last day, one of my friend, he is a private money lender. He lended 2 lakhs rupees on deposit of the title deed. The area is a flood affected area. He came and says, he doubts, he apprehends that the person who has deposited the title deed, he would go to the SRO and he would lodge a complaint before the police and said, I lost my title deed in this flood. So now the person who has lent the money is, he is apprehending that something will be happened. So he is needing an early attachment of the property. So some persons may go ahead, go straight away, otherwise he will do on the back door. That's the difficulty in it. Anyway, regarding the loss of documents, we can obtain a certified copy from the SRO. And the loss of complaint regarding the loss of document, especially in the flood related area, that will be enough. The certified copy can be used as original. And another issue is regarding the driving license. He can approach RTO, it's not much difficult now. Last one, passport regarding the document. That's also online, you can apply, and they have said that they will not charge for the charge amount for it also. And last one, the insurance claim. Usually while going through the insurance policy, you must be aware that natural calamities are avoided, excluded. So suppose of a car parked in the car post, it got affected in the flood. They would put it in the natural calamity. That's why we are seeing people who are not even towing. They are carrying the car in some other lorries or some trailers and they are taking it to the service center. Even by towing it, they fear that the insurance they will affect it. Numerous cases will be addressed on this insurance point alone, regarding the vehicles alone. In a lot of service centers, we are seeing the queue. So while addressing these issues, in my view, I have seen the people who are from ESS under the leadership of Father Martin. They are on the field. So while addressing these issues, we have to segregate the 5 issues which I have pointed out. First one, we have to point out those persons who have received 10,000, the preliminary compensation, the persons who have received preliminary compensation and the rest who are waiting for it. That's the first phase. We have to take the number and we have to start help desk for them. It can be on ward level, or it can be on local body level. Mr. Rishidas will give more clarification. But however, the government says before 30th of September, they would conduct adalats in local level. But you know how far, even by this time, how many adalats have been conducted? It's very pathetic. So we need not depend on them. We have to arrange our own help desk and legal clinics for these purposes. Before concluding, I must say, you have heard about Moolya Building Package and Smart City Package. It happened in a time when the present rehabilitation law was not in existence. At that time, the law of the land was land acquisition, which says for the public purpose, however protest will be there, they will be thrown out and they will be given the money in the market value only. Not market value, the government value only. During that juncture, even in an absence of a law, the smart city package came, the Moolya Building package came. They say a district level purchase committee was formed. District level purchase committee under the leadership of district magistrate, and property was given money was given for their rehabilitation. Similarly, in my view, in this issue also, we have to raise for a package, demand, we have to demand a package. That package must include not only houses, it must include the business concern. It must include the loss of job. It must include the law, the counseling and other aspects, the mental issues. Not only economic issues, the mental issues has also to be considered. Like in MACT, motor accident claims, tribunal cases, the compensation will be given to the mental suffering also. Why I point this? Because providing protection, protecting the life of individuals and citizens, that is a fundamental right. It is the bounden duty of the government to protect the life and liberty of individuals. And in case of natural calamity also, they have to step into the shoes of the protector. So for that aspect, we need an elaborative and comprehensive package. I think from the floor of this kind, we'll point out that some ideas will come regarding the formation of that package. So for these aspects, the help desk or the legal aid clinics that we are going to, the project, it has to act as a liaison agency. We have to liaison with the government authorities. Luckily, some of the tahsildars, tahsildar of Kochi, he is close to, associated to us very much, and whenever we got a call regarding the non-inclusion of very genuine participant, genuine flood-affected refugee, we'll call him and we'll get him included. But that is not possible in large number of cases. So we have to formulate a plan for a local level help desk to include those genuine persons who are ousted. Also to oust not genuine persons. For that we have to inform them. The section 52 of the Disaster Management Act says, making false claim is an offence. Making false claims so as to include in the project, it costs 2 years imprisonment if it is proved. Of course, it is not a cognizable offence, but it is an offence. Similarly, the department head, in the last time you have seen, some village officer was booked for this purpose. The law says the department head is having some culpable liability. He is also having, if it is even with the negligence, not actual participation, if it is proved that there was some negligence from his part, then he will also be liable. That's a deemed liability. However, I am summing up. My submission is, we have to form legal aid clinics for the purpose of inclusion, checking the persons who are included in the list. Second one, for the purpose of making this claim available to business concerns and other fishermen folk, etc. And third one, banking dealings. And fourth one, the loss of documents. We have to give proper guidance and proper methodology to the refugees. Then fifth one, the insurance claim. On these 5 points, we have to give separate addressing team. We have to form a separate addressing team on the 5 points. That's what I'm intending to put up now. Especially, we have to form on a comprehensive package. We have to raise the demand for a comprehensive package similar to Moolambilli and similar to Smart City. Though that happened at a time when there was no law at all. But now, the disaster management says it is particular in planning, organizing, coordinating and implementing. It says it's a fundamental right that government is duty bound to protect the life of an individual. Life means it's not mere animal existence. Article 21 says life means it must be, it includes all, not mere animal existence. So for that purpose, we'll march ahead. Thank you.